This is What is the Cloud? How can the cloud help you? And it is my pleasure to introduce Bill Hemmelgarn. He's the Director of Managed Services for SMS ProTech. He is a 17-year veteran in various roles of information technology, communications, and has served for over 8 years with SMS ProTech. He currently serves as the Director of Managed Services, and he's going to tell us about the cloud. So, Bill,
Thanks,
let me hook you up, and whoops, and then you can just have that backwards, don't I? However, hook yourself up.
I'll get hooked on here somehow.
Well, good morning, everyone. Thanks for coming in. Appreciate your time today. As Catherine kind of mentioned, we're going to be discussing the cloud a little bit today and some of the interesting definitions of the cloud out there today. So I'm going to get started. One of the things that kind of comes to mind is really, what is the cloud? What is cloud computing? And some interesting excerpts here from a Cisco event recently. See if I can get this guy to play. So if anybody's confused about what the cloud has to offer, I wouldn't be surprised, because just like the rest of you, I'm confused as well too. This is, I found this quite humorous when I found this the other day. Get this to play up here shortly. I hope I didn't bring speakers in. Well, we may have, this is going to take a little while with the internet service here. Anyway, the probably just skip this. But the what came out about this survey was they surveyed a number of people within this conference that was out there, just what is a cloud, and everybody's answer was pretty much the same. It was a blank stare, the deer in the headlights, like nobody had an answer for it. And that went on for probably about 25, 30 people. Finally, about the 20th person came up and says, well, I think it has something to do with angels. But so any of that, the variations out there for the cloud services as to what it actually provides is quite interesting out there. We are going to have trouble with internet today. Well, speaking of cloud services, let's go ahead and move on. From the, and I know as many of you people have probably, or I guess let me back up just 1 second. How many of you are actually cloud users out there today? Got a few out there. Can anybody give me a definition of what a cloud is?
Gigantic wide area network. The internet, basically, and other networks.
That's earns a door prize for me.
That was easy.
Isn't it technically using computer services that are hosted at maybe another source through the internet?
Yeah, that's a lot of it, what the definition is going to come around to. I know a lot of times you're going to see out there is, you know, Microsoft's doing a huge push. I'm sure everybody's seen the Microsoft commercial out there with to the cloud. And they're doing a fantastic job of branding the cloud toward themselves, but realistically, Microsoft didn't invent it. I'm sure, most of you have seen that. But this one is probably my favorite one. I would try to play it because this is where the dad sits at the end and he's supposed to be the father figure. And the wife says, the cloud gives me what my family or nature could not give me. And the guy kind of hangs his head. So it's like, I can relate to that. But contrary to what you might think, cloud computing really is not a new concept. The concept of cloud computing was, and not created by Microsoft either, was created, or the concept came up in about 1966. And it was put together by a gentleman by the name of Douglas Parkhill. And through that time, we've actually been doing cloud computing for a number of years. I mean, when you look at it, everything we do, internet-based, is cloud-related. And in 2007, Google and IBM partnered up to actually put together their solution for cloud computing, and they involved a bunch of universities and really got the cloud hyped up at that point. So now you're talking about really confusing the whole situation as to what is the cloud. Because, you know, realistically, we've all been using it for quite a number of years. But one of the main uses of cloud computing technology is what you mentioned there, has been software as a service, utilizing software provided by somebody else through the internet and making it accessible from any place, anywhere, and pretty much any device. You know, one of your most common ones that you're going to find today that's, you know, utilizing software as a service is email. You know, how many of you have a POP3 email account from your service provider home, whether it be Roadrunner, BrightNet? That is a cloud-based service. I mean, so every one of you out there probably at some point has had a POP3 email account. The other addition of it, and this has really become evident in the evolution of our internet service providers. You know, back when it was dial-up, the concept of cloud was really not prevalent. You didn't have enough bandwidth to do it. And today, with the availability, whether it be broadband cable or even fiber to your home, that bandwidth is available today. So you can do, like they show on the commercials for Microsoft, where you're actually doing video editing across the wire into the cloud. Okay, go. I thought he was leaving already, and he got a call. It's like, gee, am I that bad already?
No, he got his door prize.
Yeah. I was like, wait a minute here. Technology, isn't it great? Come on. Oh, and it's stuck on this last one yet. Excuse me one second here, I'm having a little bit of a challenge. Come on. There we go. Okay, so on to the origin of cloud computing. You know, as many of you know, that cloud computing has been around for a number of years. And you know, back in the day when we just drew the networks of cloud, you know, I remember my first days into IT work was, you know, anytime you're taking anything outside of the local physical network, a local area network, it was just portrayed as a cloud. Nobody knew where it actually went. Nobody cared how it actually got there, but it got there. You can see that, you know, remarks from, you know, Kevin Marks of Google, and you know, that's been around for quite some time. And then the first cloud networking is around, you know, the TCP/ICP abstraction, and then they move into the data abstraction, where we're actually sending clouds around into the documents, or the data and documents into the cloud. And then the emerging cloud abstracts infrastructure. Oops, too far. Muck is what Jeff Bezos from Amazon calls it, you know, where you're taking the entire cloud and now's when things getting confusing. But the beauty of the cloud is you really don't need to know what's happening out there in the real world, what's happening behind the back end, because it continues to work. And so moving on to the definition of cloud computing, this is provided by the National Institute of Standards and Technology. The interesting thing about this definition is this is on version 15 already, and the definition has actually changed 5 times within the last 18 months. Additionally as well too, if you Google cloud computing, you're going to get 47 million results in just under 0.11 seconds. So having said that, there's a number of cloud offerings out there available in the world, and
But you know, one of the things that the common metaphor that you use with cloud computing is comparing it to your utilities company, whether it be your electric, your gas, your cable. I mean, how many times when you turn on an electric switch do you really pay attention as to how that electric switch got there, how that light came on? It works along in that conjunction, conjunction with that, where you're using utility computing power, where you're not controlling the back end, you're not controlling the resources that make this happen, but it's just a matter of turning on that light switch or hitting that keyboard, and life works.